grass is what's been going on this week. And Tom, our director extraordinaire, is helping us place some of these pieces.
I would like to see these eggs, like maybe another little cluster bag.
Might be nice.
Yeah.
A couple eggs and a couple strands of
grass. I don't have time to do more grass, so it's putting me in a little bit of a crunch.
My sauces, Colonel. Yes, sir.
Year of the city, 2274.
I would say do it so that you can get it.
Tom, my friend, who is a designer, is giving us good pointers. And we've known each other for 30, more than that. Tom, I just turned 45 today.
45 years old!
45, halfway to 90, dog!
Happy birthday! Hey!
Okay. Space, the perfect place for your birthday.
Say 500 years old, or 400 or 350 years old. I'm not really sure, but it's old. Anyway, there is this UFO, and the interesting thing about this UFO.
I'm in Wisconsin on my way to the St. Paul American Craft Council show, and I just saw a dragonfly. He was flying right across the interstate.
Here I am entering Elmwood, Wisconsin, on my way to find the site of Officer George Wheeler's 1976 UFO.
Today,
on my way home from the American Craft Council show in St. Paul. It was not a very good show sales-wise.
I saw a strange glow on the top of Tunnel Hill. Assuming it was a fire, he came up to the hill with his squad car and found that it was not a fire. It was actually a craft on the hill.
He saw the craft over a limestone quarry that is still a functioning limestone. Illustrations of that encounter, and those illustrations are pretty in-depth drawings. So right now I am driving by the quarry where in 1976, on April 22nd, George Wheeler had his famous UFO sighting. It would be over